Hey guys, today I have about 30 minutes before I gotta start heading out to work, so I'm gonna do a little review on Too Faced Better Than Sex Mascara. I hear a lot about this in the beauty blogging world. It's a really good mascara, it's volumizing, makes your lashes thick and beautiful and such. And I got lucky enough to get the full size of this in a bundle along with a lot of other Too Faced products, so I got a lot of things for free, and this is basically free too because I just paid for a chocolate bar palette, I got the blush, I got an eyeshadow primer, and I also got the mascara, all full-size products for $49. So I decided to try this out and see how I feel about this, and if I like it or not, so we'll do before, which is right now, after it's applied, and after about a 6-hour shift at work when I come home, and see if it stayed on my lashes or if it gave me raccoon eyes, which I hear a lot about. The main complaint I hear about this is people getting raccoon eyes, and I hope I don't get that. I live in a dry climate, but you never know. So, here we go. First, what I like to do is curl my eyelashes with an eyelash curler, just to give it extra curl. And I'm gonna try our Better Than Sex mascara. Wand is kind of strange too. I'm not seeing that much of a difference so far. But I think we'll try two coats. So I'll just wait for that one to dry and start on the other eye in the meantime. They say you don't have to curl your eyelashes when you use mascara, but I like to do it too, just in case it doesn't work out as planned. They say that one coat you should see a big difference, but I'm not seeing much of a difference between this and a drugstore mascara. See, they look very average. The eyeshadow is also Too Faced, by the way. I got kind of stupid with my cat eye. And this is how I look today. Super smoky eye. I'm noticing it's a very wet formula too. Okay, now that the first coat's dry, I'm going to put a second coat on. Still, it's not looking anything like the photos of all these bloggers and Too Faced commercials on HSN promotes. And I have naturally thick lashes too, and it's not doing much. My lashes are just clumping together really bad. Skin formula is extremely wet. Oh, here we are after two coats. Alright, so I'm gonna go to work. I'll be back in about 6 hours and we'll see how well this mascara has held up till then. My eyes are a reflection of my life right now. This is after a shift of 6 hours. Look at how bad these raccoon circles are. Raccoon eyes. The only reason why that I was able to get away with this was because I was wearing glasses and because I'm wearing a chocolate smoky eye. If it weren't for that, I would really look like an idiot. So, this mascara, in my opinion, is not prison sex. Whoever named this mascara was obviously having some really, really bad sex. Really, I don't get it. I don't get the hype. The formula is very wet. And what I don't like about it is that, well, obviously the raccoon circles. It's just undeniable. So I made a waterproof version because I guess this is a problem with a lot of people, but I don't get why it was not waterproof in the first place. I also don't get why this product has so many rave reviews. Beauty blockers love it, but I've used toothpaste lash injection as a sample they gave me, and I loved it. It was great. It was waterproof, made my eyelashes look thicker and bigger. It was fantastic. But this one, for some reason, this is the bestseller. I'm not sure because it's just the packaging, it's this cute, pretty pink metal packaging, or what, but this is a huge loss to me. I think maybe next time around, I'll try it with the eyelash primer. I never had to use eyelash primers for anything. The only mascara I had as bad as this one was Estee Lauder's More Than Mascara, and that was horrible. It was just as bad as this. That's a completely different company. There's toothpaste that have a parent company. Yeah, I'm honestly very disappointed by this mascara, because almost everything in my makeup bag is Too Faced, except for like my foundation and my eyeliner. But yeah, to me, this is totally not worth the price. This is $23 full price on the website. I was just lucky it got this in a bundle. Anyway, I'll see you around my next video. Maybe next time I'll retry this experiment, but use an eyelash primer. So we'll see how that goes.